phone calls I received inquiring as to why I have not placed my views on the present COVID disaster that is happening in the state. Fortunately, I would like to inform each and everyone that I myself was COVID positive and was admitted in the GMC and was treated there for 11 days. I thank God for having brought me out, but I cannot forget to thank the doctors, nurses and entire staff who I observed were working tirelessly to help each and every patient that required treatment. However, we know that in this time, it is not correct to play the blame game, but we all have to positively contribute. But before that, I would like to tell the Chief Minister to tell his ministers to stop talking nonsense, where one minister has gone to the extent of saying that we are ready for the third phase. Now, if such type of stupidity is spoken out, then you are only confusing the people and creating more chaotic and confusion in the minds of the people who are already aware that we are not in a position to come out from the second phase. Mr. Chief Minister, you will agree that the state is badly battered by the mismanagement of the pandemic. And I would not like to go into the statistics, because the statistics are there before the eyes of the people. Our judiciary, when I say our judiciary, the Indian judiciary, has clearly and rightly said that a person who dies, Ji Munis, medical attention nastana, morta, ani ek bhayanak gosht ki that dying for the shortage of oxygen is nothing short of murder. Other, this is not my finding, it is the judiciary's stand, and which is very correct. It is the duty of the state to safeguard the life with basic needs of every citizen. Now, these murders that are taking place, this murderer will never be charged nor convicted. Now, where will these murders, at whose doorstep will they be at? In my opinion, it will be at the doorstep of you, Mr. Chief Minister, at your doorstep. For you are the CEO, you are in charge of the administration. Pushing the blame on each other will not work. You have to take control, you have to take responsibility, and you have to be accountable to the people of India. For the last 1 month, your government did nothing. When everybody, international forums, experts were shouting from the rooftops that the pandemic is about to unfold, and you did nothing. You spoke about celebrating 60 years of liberation with 300 crores. Instead of making these arrangements, today we have reached a state that we cannot provide a bed, we cannot provide oxygen. Such a state was allowed to happen because of you and your government's whimsical decisions of even delaying the so-called lockdown or curfew that you have now put. And why was this done? This was done because the pulls and pressures of your ministers, the greed that they had. I will give an example, and here it is.
फाल्यां टुरिझम ओपन करूंक सोदता म्हणटा जाल्यार बार एन्ड रेस्टॉरंट तुजे ओपन ना जाल्यार कोण येतलो
रेस्ट्रिक्शन कसले घालतले तुमी बार एन्ड रेस्टॉरंट ओपन करता
रेस्ट्रिक्शन काय ना आमी सोशल डिस्टन्सिंग सांगला रेस्टॉरंटांनी फॉलो करपाचे 30 टेबल आहा थिंगा 20 जाली आता न्हू 10 काडली
पण बासस्टॉरंट इज ओके पण बाराचो जो सोरो पिलो तेका सोशल डिस्टन्सिंग उरता मागीर
ना सोरो तसो पण
इट वाज एट दिस मोमेंट दैट ही न्यू ही फक्ड अप.
ये फंस गया इसे पार्टी की मीटिंग समझ के फंस गया.
दिस मिनिस्टर ऑफ योर्स आई मस्ट एडमिट इज अ ग्रेट नेशनलिस्ट बट द पीपल ऑफ हिज कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी से दैट फॉर हिम लामानीज कम फर्स्ट एंड गोंस कम आफ्टरवर्ड्स. सो इवन हिज पर्सनल स्टाफ मेनी belong to the lama. There are many. One fellow talks the show must go on. Another fellow is talking that we are ready for the third. If this type of nonsense is spoken, how do you expect people to have confidence in you and your government? I hope you will now work that the courts of Goa have intervened to at least provide a bed and give that confidence that the patient basic need of oxygen will be provided. Mr. Chief Minister, I would like to tell you that a leader is not one who is perfect and successful every time. But with grace, the leader should admit that I have failed. And here, you and your government have failed. There is no doubt about it. From tomorrow, let us hope that you improve the situation. We can only hope. But are we going to be in a position of hope and die in despair? Will you allow this to continue? Is a question mark which you have to answer. Your government, according to me, at this point of time, which is a cry and a call of every sane person in Goa, in fact, it is a cry of your own medical cell chief saying appoint an expert committee. But an expert committee with full autonomy to take decisions, financial and otherwise, to put things in order, to bring us out of this mess. Every time you are of the, you come and you say, I will be putting this in order. I will be putting this in order within 24 hours. Mr. Chief Minister, you are playing with lives. Do not try trial and error methods. Use an experts and use scientific methods and bring us out of this traumatic situation. If not, you should ease out gracefully. In these suffering moments of humanity, my question to everyone would be, do we hear the voice of God in the cries of the people? Yes. It is among the cries of the people that the voice of God is there. And it is time for each and every one of us to wake up and support, help, and minimum console people who are found and trapped in traumatic conditions. It could be, they may be found COVID positive, some have no daily bread. In whatever way, at least the least we can do is console. And I appeal to everyone to pray to the Almighty that He shows His mercy upon us. He has showed it upon me and my family so many times. Miracles do happen with prayers. I appeal to pray and see miracles happening. That in such prayer, many lives will be saved. God bless you.